This is a stimulus check update and daily news report. Got a lot of news to cover in this video. So the good news is that parents are getting those $250 to $300 checks today. We'll go over this article right here. Fourth stimulus check update, $2,000 direct aid payments could be approved now. Foreclosures are up 67% in the third quarter of 2021. When it comes to that big package, Kyrsten Sinema and Joe Manchin are basically forcing the Democrats to break up that $3.5 trillion package into two different bills. One for 2021, one for 2022, and Democrats are making their demands of what they want passed now. When it comes to the IRS spying on bank accounts, I'm going to play a video clip you don't want to miss from Elizabeth Warren defending this, and you want to hear her answer of this question of banks being able to, of IRS being able to spy on people's bank accounts. Then I'll answer the questions you leave for me in the comments. Hope you're having a fantastic Friday. If you appreciate the fact-based, fast-paced updates, hit the like button down below, and I'm giving $200 checks to my subscribers, and I'll talk more about that later on in the video. But first, Child Tax Credit 2021, when will the IRS deposit the fourth check? So that is coming today, and actually, if you're getting a direct deposit, you should have seen it pending maybe a few days ago, but today, October 15th, is when the fourth Child Tax Credit payment should hit bank accounts. If it's not in your bank account, you could get it a paper check, probably going to be mailed out today, so probably within a week or two. Let me know down in the comments below if you got your child tax credit yet. If you didn't and you want to check your payments, you could go to the IRS child tax credit portal right here, and you could check to see if you're enrolled in advanced payments, unenroll, update your bank account and mailing address, view your payments. So you get all the information right there if you haven't gotten your child tax credit yet. When it comes to a fourth stimulus check, let's go over this article right here. So fourth stimulus check update, $2,000 direct aid payments could be approved now. I'm going to be honest, this is a very misleading article and headline. It cannot be approved now. The reason why is because a fourth stimulus check is not in that big package. It's not in any package, actually. So therefore, it could not be approved. Lately, there haven't been any politicians trying to push for a fourth stimulus check, but a new study came out by Capital One Insight Center shows that the three stimulus checks were not enough and a fourth direct aid payment would move the U.S. economy in the right direction. So it goes over a few different statistics here of why a fourth stimulus check is necessary throughout this article, basically saying a study found that 46% of low-income Americans needed the money to cover basic expenses. And a lot of other reasons why a fourth stimulus check would be necessary. But in terms of a fourth stimulus check, it is not in that big package. And then it says, this campaign for a fourth stimulus check and more just hit a key milestone. What this article is talking about is this petition right here for the fourth stimulus check of $2,000 per month to every American, currently at 2,927,000 signatures so far. As I mentioned before, there is no fourth stimulus check in that package. So if you hear some other YouTuber or article saying that, I want to tell you the truth. There is no fourth stimulus check. But the thing is, with the two packages breaking up now, it could be a possibility that maybe the second package, the second part, might have it due to if the economy goes down during the fall and winter with cases on the rise. There is potential, but just want to let you know it's not in there as of now. When it comes to foreclosures are surging now that COVID mortgage bailouts are ending, but they're still at low levels. So what it's saying here is pandemic-related mortgage bailouts are ending and foreclosures are now rising. Foreclosures starts jumped 32% in the third quarter of this year from the second quarter, and we're 67% higher than the third quarter of 2020. Now, the reason I think for that, why it was higher than 2020, is because we had all of that stimulus money keeping people in their homes, not being able to be evicted, and which is the reason why now, with a lot of that money dried up, 67% higher for foreclosures. And it's saying here, the foreclosure numbers should stay relatively low because of aggressive modifications by lenders and also because of high levels of home equity. So this could be bad, could get worse. We'll see what happens. I'll keep you updated on that. When it comes to the big package, so Kyrsten Sinema, one of the Senate Democrats who is kind of holding up this reconciliation bill, says won't support a reconciliation bill without passing infrastructure, and she is sticking to her guns and is not letting up at all. This is Kyrsten Sinema right here, along with Joe Manchin. And as a result, Kyrsten Sinema trails potential primary challengers in progressive polls. So for the upcoming election, Kyrsten Sinema may not get reelected. And if it was any other year, I'm sure the Democrats wouldn't care. But because the Democrats need every single Democrat they could get in the Senate, you know, they kind of need her. So this could be disastrous as well for the Democratic Party. And then it could switch to the Republicans, and then it'll switch back to the Democrats and switch back and forth. And we'll hear all this craziness back and forth. Progressives urge Pelosi to keep all the social and climate programs in Biden's economic plan intact. So as I mentioned before in the top of the video, that the big package, $3.5 trillion package, is probably going to be split up into two different bills because Joe Manchin and Kyrsten Sinema do not want to pass it as full. So they're kind of floating the idea of splitting it up. And so progressives want to make sure that the social and climate programs are in at least this part. So House Progressive urged Speaker Nancy Pelosi to keep all the proposed policies in President Joe Biden's economic plan, but keep them in place for fewer years to reduce costs. Democrats are deciding whether to cut entire programs or reduce their timeframes, or some combination of both, to lower the proposal's $3.5 trillion price tag and appease centrists. And the party aims to pass the investment in the social safety net and climate policy, along with the bipartisan infrastructure bill, by the end of the month. So we'll see what happens. The deadline is October 31st, which is just about 2 weeks away. So we'll see if it gets broken up, if it gets reduced in size, what goes in it, what gets taken out of it. So there's going to be a lot of changes going on. Now, one of the big questions of that package that will affect our everyday life, is Biden really planning to spy on your bank account? So I mentioned this in another video, that the IRS, because of this big package that's going to come out, the IRS will have the ability to look at anybody's bank account that has more than $600 in it, which is almost everybody if you think about it. Here is a video clip of Elizabeth Warren being asked this question point blank, and here's a response.
You have been a tireless advocate for the working person for years at this point. I'm curious to get your response to the administration's request at this point to have banks have reports for any withdrawal or deposit for any American's bank account over $600.
So I think that actually they've changed the numbers on this. Part of what we want to make sure is that everybody pays the taxes that they owe. And most people do. Anybody who works for a living and gets a W-2 form, the government already receives a report on exactly how much money you made. But there is some concern that there are some people who are moving a lot of money in and out of their accounts in the banks without making proper reports to the IRS, or perhaps engaged in other kinds of activities. And so they just want to step up the level of information that the IRS has available. And I think that's reasonable. You just got to get the number right.
And speaking of that muscle, many people have suggested that President Biden's agenda or wish list, if you will, has really been overshadowed by the realities of that 50-50 split in the Senate, with Republicans relying on the filibuster. Now, as we are just a little over a year out from the midterm elections, what do you feel that Democrats must do in order to prove to the American people that they can effectively pass new legislation and govern?
We need to deliver. Look, we've already done a big part of it. We got the vaccinations out, and they are now available to everyone, and that's great. We got those checks for $1,200 out that we promised we would do. We've gotten child tax credits out to families with children. But now we have our toes on the line to make big change. Think of it this way. More than 100 years ago, we started investing in America, in roads and bridges and sewers and water lines and public schools and colleges and universities, in order to build a more prosperous country, and it worked. But starting about 40 years ago, we really laid back on all that while the rest of the world kept investing. Now here we are, 2021, we need to invest in childcare so daddies and mamas can go to work. We need to invest in increasing the wages of every childcare worker and preschool teacher in America. We need to invest in home and community-based care. We need to invest in Medicare expansion to cover dental, vision, and hearing. And we need to take a big hit back at the climate crisis that's facing us. In effect, We need to rebuild a lot of those roads and bridges for the climate catastrophe that is bearing down on us. We do those things and we make ourselves a more prosperous nation going forward, and we expand opportunity. So it's not there just for a handful at the top. It's there for everyone.
Are you concerned that your more moderate colleagues, Senators Joe Manchin and Kyrsten Sinema, have a little bit too much control over what becomes law at this point?
Look, it's tough when you have the thinnest, skinniest possible majority, which is what the Democrats have right now. But keep in mind, everything that I've just talked about is what Americans want to see. Not just very, very progressive Americans, not just Democrats. Democrats, Republicans, independents, the majority, big majorities of Americans want to see us deliver on child care, deliver on expanded Medicare, deliver on the climate crisis. So it's up to all of us to say, we're going to get here. I get that we all may have differences, but nobody is getting everything they wanted. That's what happens in a negotiation. We need to negotiate, but we need to do it quickly, and we need to deliver on behalf of the American people.
What are your thoughts on what Elizabeth Warren has to say earlier on when she answered that question about the $600 in the bank account? Basically saying the only people who have something to worry about are the ones who are doing something wrong. Is that justified, though? Like, should they have access to the bank accounts? Let me know your thoughts on all that down in the comments below. So Elizabeth Warren isn't budging on reconciliation top line. Other side should make demand clear. So it is pretty much a war within the Democratic Party. The progressives such as Elizabeth Warren and Pramila Jayapal, AOC, they want to keep it at $3.5 trillion, maybe even higher if they could. But the centrist moderates, basically two of them, Joe Manchin and Kyrsten Sinema, are kind of holding everything up and want it to be a lot lower. So we'll keep you updated on what goes on with that. Next, I'm going to answer the questions you leave for me in the comments. Terry North, about the Social Security hike, also heard they would be increasing the payments they hold out of our Social Security checks. Is this true? I have not heard this. If you let me know the source of this, I haven't heard anything being withheld from the checks as well. Also, looks like the spammers are back, so this isn't me. Same logo, but it actually has an exclamation point instead of an I, so it doesn't even really say Wise Flies, but if you see these type of comments, ignore it. I would never ask you for your information. Just click it and report as spam. I don't want anyone, mistakenly think it's me and then give away money or information, so just be really careful. I try my best to get rid of it, but yeah, there's only so much I could do. So a descendant of Israel asks, I'm lost. What are the new checks coming Friday? So today, Friday, are the child tax credits. Those are the $250 to $300 per month going out on the 15th of every month. So October 15th, then November 15th, then December 15th. And then the other half of the child tax credits everybody gets in January. Next question comes from Russell Young. 5.9% is not enough, especially since everything is costing more. Do the politicians not care no more? Please answer that, David. Do they care? Why or why not? Yeah, that's a great point you have there. I don't think that's up to the politicians. I think it's up to the Social Security Administration, which I guess is sort of, done by politicians. But yeah, 5.9% with food prices on the rise, and they're saying that it could get even higher. Gas prices really high as well. And then heating costs for the winter coming up is going to be really brutal as well. So do they care? Well, I guess it's who they care about more, themselves or the people. That's the real question there. And I think they care about more about themselves. Next question comes from, why are they blaming social media and the use of people for not getting this stuff passed? Well, it seems like the blame is everywhere else but the actual cause of what's going on, unfortunately. Anyways, that is all the stimulus news I have for you today to hopefully cheer you up a bit. Here's my daughter Bella's tip of the day.
Hi guys, this is Bella. This is the tip of the day. I want to tell you something that you should always, always do. Sometimes just sit on your bed or like sit at a table on like your counter and like sit down and take like 10 breaths. Breathe in and breathe out. Because you need yourself to feel relaxed. And that's all I wanted to tell you for today. Bye.
Thank you so much for watching. Appreciate your support. As I mentioned earlier, I'm giving out $200 checks to my subscribers, and I'll have more details to that down in the description below. I have the exact instructions of what to do. Basically, you have to be subscribed to this channel, my other two channels, and then there'll be more details on that down in the description below. So check that out if you want a chance to win $200. Hope you have an amazing weekend. And if you want to check out any of my other videos, you could click up here. Actually, this is a citrus juicer review I did with my two daughters. So if you want to check out me and Bella and Kalea in this video, you could click this video up here. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Be safe. Thank you for watching.